Reggae is a people music.
People coming together.
Ooh, yeah.
You know you're a superstar.
All right,
I am a superstar.
I wanna jam it with you.
There's a war going on.
We're jumping.
You can't separate the music and the message.
Cause every day we pay the price.
And what is the message?
Sacrifice.
Peace.
Oh, life is worth much more than gold.
Being from the Caribbean, Bob holds a special place in our hearts. You know, we all grow up with Bob, and there's a reverence for the man himself. You know, for me personally, it was definitely a lifelong dream. And at the same time, it was something that, you know, I didn't even realize that I wasn't ready to be a part of, that the world wasn't ready for this movie, you know, 18 years ago when I was like, oh man, I want to try and pitch and be a part of this. You know, when we read in the paper 5 years ago that Ziggy was, you know, ready to tell this story and ready to bring, you know, his father's legacy to the screen, that gave a confidence, you know, to say, okay, now is the time, the world is ready. And you know, the thing about Ziggy is he's such a pure soul, he's such a visionary. And when he believes, there is no hesitation. So any nervousness, any sort of unworthiness, or thing, all of that goes out the window. You know, you sit with him and you feel his passion and you feel his humility and grace for this story. You know, for us, it was like, all right, there was no doubt that somehow this was going to get made, you know?
Yeah, when Frankie called me up, and graciously invited me into this process, he didn't even finish the sentence. And I was like, absolutely. I mean, it's iconic. I mean, Bob Marley means so much to so many people. It was an honor to be able to tell his story. So there was not a second's hesitation.
Is really being able to closely and authentically depict the life and life story of Bob. How was there a challenge with that? How important was it to reflect that story to its truest?
We really wanted to, you know, I mean, again, it's all about it's such a he's such an icon, and we really wanted to get this right. Having the ability to sit and talk to Ziggy and the family, the people who lived with him and loved him and spent all that time with him. We knew we were in good hands in terms of keeping us on track in terms of authenticity. We did a ton of research. I mean, Frankie already had, you know, he was such a Marley aficionado by the time this even started. It's funny, when we started the research process, I said, well, I'd like to read a few books. And he literally pulled out, he said, which one do you want? He had every single book ever written on Bob already. So, you know, we had that. So, yeah, it was very important to be as specific as possible. And then even on set, Ziggy was there the entire time, and friends of Bob and family members who could say Bob would do something this way or this gesture or that word or that phrase. So we really had the ability to keep it as authentic as possible.
Were you too happy with the ultimate and final outcome of this project?
I was walking on air at the end of the screening, at the end of the I was so happy. I mean, really, really. And to share it with an audience and to see the reaction. You know, we have the luxury of sitting there knowing what's coming and to see it work. You know, you say, okay, wait till this scene happens, wait till that scene. And to see that audience ebb and flow and then ultimately cheer and sing along. It was great. I thought, I mean, Kingsley, Lashana, Ray Green, who directed the movie, everybody just did such a phenomenal job. It's eerie watching an actor transform into another person. And you'll see, if you haven't seen it yet, it is just astounding. Some of those scenes when he's on stage and just becomes Bob is just, you get chills. It was really, really magic.
It's to echo Terry's point. I mean, the cast and the crew and the studio and the production, you know, they put their all into this. And, you know, we were at least, you know, we were honored and privileged to play even a small part in, you know, adding to this legacy of this legend. And so again, to come out of that screening, it just felt like it was on Bob's birthday. You know, there was so much magic in the air, you know, so much inexplicable things. And, you know, that was part of his journey, right? There were so many moments that were, you know, unexplainable. And, you know, it's hard to even say, all right, well, it was this book or this moment. It's just, you know, you felt an essence of something bigger than ourselves. I was saying to someone what was cool. I was going through the airport the other day, and I saw the Bob was on the Life magazine, and man, for a second, I'm like, oh man, the movie we wrote is thick. But you almost, it's like a different thing. If it would have been like a character that Terry and I created, it'd be a different kind of swagger. You're like, oh my gosh, look at what we did. It's on Life magazine. But you realize that had literally nothing to do with us, right? That we happened to write a movie, but Bob Marley is on Life magazine for being Bob Marley, right? For his message, for his impact in the world. And we just got to play a small part in you know, crystallizing part of that legacy in this format. And that is, again, it's so humbling that it's, again, hard to look at it any other way.